Very good morning, students. In our last class, we have seen the introduction to network security, and also we discussed the definition to computer security, how we are going to provide the security to our computer system, whether it is autonomous or a well-connected IT infrastructure, how we are going to provide the security, and in what terms we are considering this security. All these things we have discussed in our last class. So we said basically the cryptography, it is a broad study of different concepts, and we said we are going to discuss the cryptographic algorithms like symmetric encryption, asymmetric encryption algorithms, and we said data integrity algorithms, and authentication protocols also we are going to discuss. And afterwards we have seen the definition to computer security, and we have seen the CIA trades, what is confidentiality, integrity, and authentic availability. And we said not only the CIA trades, but the security professionals, they thought that there is a requirement of achieving authenticity as well as accountability. So the five different terms, I mean, whenever we are providing the security to a particular system or to an IT infrastructure, we have to focus on these five terms, isn't it? Confidentiality, integrity, availability, authenticity, and accountability. So in terms of these five, we have three CIA traits and two additional concepts. So if you provide these things to any IT infrastructure or any autonomous system, so we said we are achieving the security. And we also said ideally it is very difficult to gain a perfect security model. Isn't it? Whenever we are designing a security model, definitely whatever type of security, whatever level of encryption you are performing, but ultimately end of the day, that security model or that encryption algorithm is also prone to threats. At some point, today or tomorrow, at some point, what they do, what the what we call hackers or what the third parties will do means they will definitely break your network, and they will definitely hack the data. So ideally we said it is very difficult to achieve a fully secured autonomous system or a fully secured IT infrastructure. That is the reason why the development, or we can say the advancement, it is a never-ending process. Whatever technological developments are happening in the real-time scenarios, definitely they are prone to our network. They are prone to our IT infrastructure. Let us assume one simple example. We say in order to prevent or in order to protect our network, we are installing a highly configured, what we call advanced firewall to our network. We'll assume in this way. We have a private network. Let us assume our college network. Here we have different computer labs. We have the library system. We have administration systems. All these systems, if we consider them as a network, as a private network, then in order to protect this private network, what we have to do? We have to provide, or we have to give security to it. And in terms of that security, what I am suggesting to the management, or what I am suggesting to the people here, is to install a firewall, isn't it? So that a third party from the internet, from the outside world, using a computer or using a mobile device, he cannot enter into our private network. So I am suggesting them to use a highly configured or advanced firewall. So they are bringing that firewall and they are installing into their network to provide the security. They are doing it today. Let us assume that they are doing it today. After some time, what will happen? Like after 4 years, 5 years, or after 10 years, if your firewall is highly advanced, it will last up to 10 years. After 10 years, what will happen? Automatically, your technology, whatever you are using, it will become outdated. Isn't it? It will become outdated. Once the technology or once the firewall becomes outdated, what will happen? Again, your network will become prone to threats. Again, your network, again, your private network will become vulnerable. So this is what happening in our real-time scenarios. That is the reason why the technological advancements, whatever is happening in terms of security, in terms of network security or in terms of computers, IT infrastructure, they are a never-ending process. They are a never-ending process. So that is the reason why we are studying this subject, to gain some basic knowledge about the security. So quickly, in today's class, we'll be discussing. So in previous class, we have seen the definition to the computer security. In today's class, we will see what are the different types of threats we have in outside world. How the threats have been categorized, we will discuss one by one in detail. Okay, so quickly, if you get into, we have the first topic, we have cryptographic attacks. So whatever cryptographic algorithms we are using, the persons or the third parties or the intruders or the hackers, they try to crack those cryptographic algorithms, and they will try to gain the message from that ciphertext. Whatever ciphertext, after performing the cryptography, whatever ciphertext we are generating, they will try to gain the actual message or the plain text from that ciphertext. So I have given the full terminology in my last class itself. Once again, I will quickly revise that one. So how these cryptography will work means, first of all, whatever actual message you want to send, that message we are calling it as plain text, isn't it? We are calling that text as plain text, and it will be the actual text, whatever we are transmitting. Okay, the actual text. So what we do on this plain text, or we give this plain text to the encryption algorithm. What we are doing? We are giving this plain text as an input to the encryption algorithm. Let us assume this as your encryption algorithm. Okay, so over here, encryption. What we are performing? We are performing the encryption. So after performing encryption, what will happen? You will get ciphertext. Ciphertext or scrambled text. I told you to remember this ciphertext as scrambled text, isn't it? If a third party will read that ciphertext, he will not get anything. So then what we are doing? We are transmitting over the channel, over the public channel, we are transmitting this ciphertext. So all these things will do at the receiver, sender end, isn't it? All these things we have to do at sender location. At sender end, we have to do all these things. So here your sender will be present. Here your sender will be present. Your sender is responsible for performing encryption. Okay, he's having the plain text, performing the encryption, gaining the ciphertext. So then what we are doing? We are transmitting this ciphertext over the public channel. So that it will reach the destination, or it will reach the receiver. Clear? We are transmitting this over the public channel. So this is your public channel. Public channel is nothing but your internet, isn't it? Public channel is nothing but your internet, public network, internet. So what they do? They are transmitting this ciphertext over the public channel. Like this, they will transmit. So after this, you will be having the receiver. So the receiver will receive the message. So whatever you are transmitting, that same message will be received by the receiver. So that ciphertext he will receive. So after receiving the ciphertext, what he will do? He will perform. He will give that ciphertext to decryption process. Once the decryption process completes, again, what he will get? He will get the plain text. This I have explained in my last class as well. Again, I am just giving the revision to it. How this cryptography, this entire thing, we are calling it as the study of cryptography, performing the encryption, performing the decryption, okay, converting the plain text into ciphertext and converting back ciphertext, plain text from ciphertext. All these things we are calling it as the study of cryptography, okay, the study of cryptography. So here, so on this cryptography, there are two types of attacks. There are two types of possible attacks, that is passive attacks as well as active attacks. So what is passive attack and what is active attack, we will see in detail. So quickly go to the passive attack thing. So passive attacks, so here what will happen? Whenever you are transmitting over the channel, there are possible threats. On the internet only, we are going to have the possible threats, where the intruders or where the threats are present in the sense on the internet itself. So here there is a possibility of intruders, or we can also say in short threats. Threats, they can be human beings or they can be any software programs. Threats in the sense, yeah, humans, nothing but intruders as well as hackers, we call them as humans. And then software programs, nothing but your viruses, worms, all these things, they are called as threats. Okay, threats can be in the form of humans or they can be in the form of software programs, isn't it? So that I'm writing over here. So our threats, they can be either humans or they can be either what we call software programs. Software programs. So when we are saying humans, they are nothing but intruders. Intruders, or they are hackers. Hackers. Then software programs, your virus, worm, Trojan horse, or any other malware, isn't it? Malware, or there are different things that we can consider under the software programs that we are quite familiar with these things. Okay, so threats, they can. There are two different types of possibilities. Either they can be humans or they can be software programs. So whenever we are connecting to the public network, so we are prone to these threats. Whenever we are connecting to the internet, whenever we are connecting to the public network without any security, without any firewall or without any antivirus, anti-malware software in our computer, and we are directly connecting to the internet, we are prone to these threats. Threats, they can be in the form of humans or they can be in the form of software programs. Clear? So we are considering them, these threats, we are considering them as opponents, because they are not positive things, isn't it? They are not positive things. That is the reason why we are considering them as opponents. So quickly, so the opponents either eavesdrops or monitor the transmission. What they will do, eavesdropping in the sense, they will gain the access and they will steal the data. They will steal the message. Whatever you are transmitting, they will steal it. Eavesdropping in the sense, they will capture the data or they will take the data from your transmission. Or they can simply monitor. They won't do anything. They won't capture or they won't do anything. They will simply monitor the transmission. So these two types of attacks, we are calling them as passive attacks. In terms of passive attacks, what the opponent will do, either he eavesdrop or he will monitor the transmission. The goal in both the cases, what is the goal? To gain some information. Okay, to obtain the information from the transmission. Okay, so then, yeah, there are two types of passive attacks. How many different types of passive attacks we have in the sense? Two types. The first one is release of message content and traffic analysis. So release of message content, this is something like if you are transmitting a file or if you are transmitting a message to your friend or to your trusted party. So what this what this opponent or intruder will do means, let us assume that you are speaking on mobile phone. You are speaking on mobile phone with your friend and you are sharing some confidential information with your friend, and a third party is also there in that call. Without your knowledge or without your friend's knowledge, a third party is also listening to the message whatever you are giving to your friend. So such type of attack, we are calling it as a release of message under passive attack. We are calling it as a release of message content under passive attack. Because why we are saying it as passive means, neither the receiver is aware that an attack has been occurred, nor the sender is aware that an attack has been occurred. So that is the reason why we are calling such type of attack as passive attack. Clear? Such type of attack as passive attack. So hopefully you got the idea. You can remember this release of message content as an telephone conversation. Okay. Suppose if you are doing a telephonic conversation and a third party is listening to that conversation, such type of attack we are considering it as release of message under passive attacks, release of message content. Under passive attack, release of message content. Simply, you are speaking to your friend and you are sharing some confidential information, and a third person, a third party, an intruder, an opponent, what he is doing? He is listening to your telephone conversation. He is listening to your telephonic conversation without making any noise, without giving any disturbance in that call. So what it means? He is gaining the information. He is gaining that message without the knowledge of either the sender or the receiver. Clear? Such type of attack, we are calling it as release of message content under passive attack. So the next thing is a traffic analysis. So to understand this one, how this traffic analysis is a passive attack, to understand this thing, I'm taking an example of two rival countries. Okay, let us take the South Korea and North Korea. They two are rival countries. Isn't it? They two are rival countries. So in that, what the rival countries generally they do? They will attack on each other, isn't it? What the rival countries will do means they will attack on each other. So let us assume the situation is high. The situation is like a war zone kind of thing between those two countries, between North Korea and South Korea. So at that peak point, at that high point, let us assume the South Korea is continuously sending some messages to China. Okay, we have North Korea. I will take that example on our whiteboard. Okay, I will take that example over here so that you will understand what is traffic analysis. So we have South Korea and we have North Korea. They two are neighboring countries like India and Pakistan. Okay, North Korea, so they share some common border, and the situation, we said it is something like a war zone, isn't it? The war zone is going on, war is going on. In between that war, what the South Korea, because in between South Korea and China, we have North Korea. We have North Korea. So at the time of some heated situation, some war kind of situation, what South Korea is doing, he's continuously sending the messages. He's continuously sending the messages to China. What South Korea is doing, he's simply sending the messages to China. So what it indicates, and what this North Korea is doing means, he is not reading those messages. Simply he is monitoring. He is doing the traffic analysis. He is doing the traffic analysis, and he is considering that South Korea is continuously sending some messages to China. South Korea is continuously sending some messages to China. So what it indicates to North Korea? He is not reading those messages. He is just doing the traffic analysis. With the traffic analysis only, he is understanding that South Korea is seeking the help of China so that they both can attack on North Korea. So in that way, traffic analysis over here, what North Korea is doing, he's analyzing the traffic. He's doing the analysis on the traffic which is sent from South Korea to China. So in that way, this traffic analysis is helpful, is an advantageous thing to North Korea in gaining the information that South Korea is seeking the help of China. He's not reading those messages. He's simply doing the analysis of that traffic. So in that sense, North Korea is gaining some advantage by simply doing the traffic analysis. So this kind of attack also, we are calling it as passive attack, because here North Korea is monitoring that traffic. North Korea is doing the traffic analysis. Neither China knows nor South Korea knows that one. Isn't it? Nobody knows that one. See, they are sitting idle and they are doing the analysis of this traffic. They are not reading. They are not capturing the messages. They are simply doing the analysis. Okay. They are simply doing the traffic analysis. And with that traffic analysis only, they are understanding that these two countries, they are forming an alliance so that they can attack. The both can attack on North Korea. So this type of transmission, what we said, it is traffic analysis. So here, the example of rival countries, you can remember. Example of rival countries. You can remember this example. Okay, to understand this traffic analysis, how North Korea is doing the traffic analysis, which has been done between South Korea and China, and with that traffic analysis only, they are analyzing that South Korea is seeking the alliance of China. So in that sense, the traffic analysis is helpful. In that sense, an attack on the transmission is being done. And this type of attack, we said the traffic analysis under passive attack. So this example you have to remember. The next thing, yeah, here you can understand that one. So as the third party or the opponent, he is not going to change any information. He's not going to change any information in both the scenarios. He's either in the telephone conversation example or in the traffic monitoring. Nowhere the opponent is changing the information under transmission. So here neither the sender is aware of that transmission nor the receiver is aware of that transmission. So here, if you consider this image, here Bob, he is the sender of information, and Alice, she is the receiver of the information. And here Darth, what he is doing, he is simply gaining the advantage from the transmission. He is not doing any changes to the transmission. And in between these two parties, we have this public network. This entire thing, whatever is shown as a cloud, whatever is shown like a cloud over here, this is nothing but your public network. Generally, to represent public network, we use cloud symbol. Okay, so this cloud is nothing but your public network, and this public network is prone to threats, and your presence of Darth under this transmission is nothing but a threat only. He is a threat over here. So what he is doing, he is simply gaining the information. Gaining the information by doing the first one, that what we said, release of message content type of attack, or the second one that is traffic analysis. In either way, he is gaining the information from the public network, so which is completely unknown to Bob as well as Alice, sender as well as receiver. So these type of attack, we are calling it as passive attack, and it is very difficult to detect. Passive attacks are very difficult to detect because there is no alteration to the data. There is no alteration to the actual data. Okay. So the next category, that is next type of attacks, are active attacks. Okay. In active attacks, the data will be modified. Okay. It is not compulsory that the data will be modified always. So generally, what will happen in case of active attack, the data will get modified. So again, active attacks, there are four different categories. The first one, masquerade. The second one, reply, replay, sorry. The third one, modification of message. And the fourth one, denial of service. Okay, denial of service. Okay, we'll go to a diagrammatic representation like how I have explained this passive attack. In that same way, I will explain the active attack. So this diagram, if you consider, here what is happening? Here again, we have two parties. Our first party is Bob. Okay, the first party is Bob. Okay, he is the sender. And the second party is Alice. She is the receiver of the message. Alice is the receiver of the message. And we also have a third party. This is our third party. And he is nothing but, you can consider him as threat or opponent or intruder, whatever. Okay, basically it is an threat. Okay, he's a bad guy, we can say. Bad guy on the internet. Okay, so it is, so like three parties. Our first party is the, always you remember, whenever I am saying a third party, you have to consider him as a bad guy. Okay, or a less familiar person or less known person. Okay, like that you can consider. Our sender, he is always the first person. Who is the first person? Sender is the first person. Always second person is the receiver. So in our terminology, we use these words whenever required. Okay. So when I am saying the first person, you have to consider him as the sender. And when I am saying the second person, you have to consider him as the receiver. And when I am saying the third person or third party, this he is nothing but the less known person or the bad guy on the internet. Okay, hacker, intruder, threat, like that you have to consider. So here, whenever the sender is sending the message to the receiver, the third party is going to be present on the internet. The third party is going to be present on the internet. And using the IT infrastructure, whenever we are transmitting the message, definitely we have to depend on the public network. Isn't it? Definitely, we have to depend on the public network because we cannot pull a direct cable between the two parties. Isn't it? It is very difficult. It is highly impossible to pull a separate leased line or dedicated cable between the two parties. Because somebody is sitting in Hyderabad and somebody, okay, party one is sitting in Hyderabad and party two may sit in New York, New Jersey or in Delhi, like that. So we can't pull a separate cable, a dedicated cable between the two parties. If you pull that cable, okay, the chapter is over, we can say. There is no need to provide any security. If you pull a dedicated cable between the two parties. As pulling a cable between the two parties, it is very difficult. We have to depend on the public network, isn't it? Simply, we are connecting to the public network and we are throwing our packet, we are throwing our message into this public network. Ultimately, that message, okay, will be routed, okay, to the second party. That is nothing but the receiver. So, in between that, anybody can capture that message. Anybody can capture that message. And that capturing party, we are considering him as the third party. Okay, we are considering him as the third party. So, in active attacks, in case of masquerade, the first type of active attack, as we have seen, the first type of active attacks, the masquerade, to explain this, what he will do means, he will, okay, he is going to behave like the sender. The third party is going to behave like the first party and he simply sends some unusual messages to the receiver. Some unusual messages to the receiver so that he will gain the advantage of that transmission. So let us assume that Bob is the trusted party, isn't it? Bob is the trusted party and Alice is also trusted party. And this is untrusted third party. Okay, untrusted third party, less known, less familiar person. So what he will do means he will gain the access to the transmission. Whatever transmission will generally happen between Bob and Alice, Darth will gain the access to that transmission channel. Gain the access to that transmission channel. So now what Darth will do means he will behave like Bob. He will behave like Bob because if he behave like Darth, Alice will not trust him, isn't it? Alice will not trust. So what he will do, what Darth will do means he will behave like Bob. By behaving like Bob, he sends messages to Alice. He sends messages to Alice. Okay. So let us assume Darth, what he is doing? He is sending a message to Alice that, okay, deposit some 10,000 rupees into my account. He is saying, deposit some 10,000 rupees into my account, and he is giving some account number as well into that message. So what Alice will do now? Alice will think that the message is from Bob. The message is from, okay, trusted person, Bob. So what she will do? She will deposit that amount. Okay, whatever number, account number he is sending, she will deposit that amount into that account number. So in that sense, okay, a masquerade. So right now in this scenario, when he is sending this message to the Alice, okay, by behaving like Bob, so here he is acting like masquerade. Darth is acting like masquerade. How he is acting? He is acting like a masquerade by simply sending some unwanted, unusual message to Alice and gaining the advantage from that transmission. Darth is behaving like a masquerade. So the next, second thing. So in this, yeah, in this transmission, we have shown three numbers over here. Number one, number two, number three. So the masquerade is this number two. Only Darth is sending message to Alice. The Bob is completely unaware that Darth is sending message to Alice. Isn't it? Bob is completely unaware of this message. So here we have to consider only this line from Darth to Alice. Okay, this is an example for masquerade. This is an example for masquerade. The second one, the second type of what we call active attack is replay. Replay is, okay, here we have, in this arrow marks, you have to consider 1, 2, and 3. You have to consider all 1, 2, and 3. So generally what will happen, so this to explain the second type of active attack, that is replay attack. The third party, the untrusted party, he will gain the message. He will gain the actual message. He will gain the actual message. So let us say Bob is sending a message to Alice that meet me. The message is meet me at 10 a.m. Meet me at 10 a.m. Okay. So this message Bob is sending to Alice. Bob is sending to Alice. So now, so this message, it will go in two directions, because Darth is gaining that message. Darth is stealing this, stealing that message from the transmission. So Darth will also have that message, as well as Alice will also have that message. Now, after gaining that message, what Darth will do means he will modify a portion of this message and he will continuously send that message to Alice so that Alice will get confused. So that Alice will get confused. So now this meet me at 10 a.m. message is with Alice as well. Isn't it? Is with Alice as well. So the first message she received, like meet me at 10 a.m. Meet me at 10 a.m. So now what Darth will do means he will simply modify, because he is also gaining that message from this one channel. He is also gaining that message. So now what Darth will do means he will modify that message and make that message as meet Darth at 9 a.m. Meet Darth at 9 a.m. Like this he is modifying. So now she will get confused whether she has to meet Bob or she has to meet Darth. She will get confused. Or he can even do like this. Instead of sending the second message, what he will do, Darth will do means meet me at 11 a.m. One more message he is sending simply. Again, he will send one more message. Meet me at 12 a.m. Okay. So like this, he will continuously send more than one message with different timings or with different message content, so that Alice will get confused. So now she's in confusion whether he has to meet Bob at 10 a.m., 11 a.m., 12 a.m., when she has to meet. So in that way, in order to gain some kind of advantage, what the intention of Darth is, he don't want Bob and Alice to meet, isn't it? He don't want Bob and Alice to meet. So what he's doing, he's simply changing the content of that message. He's simply changing the content of actual message and keep on doing the replay. Keep on doing the replay with different message content, with different message content, or by simply altering some portion of that message so that he's making the second party confused. He's making the second party confused. So this is the second type of active attack, that is replay. So the third type of active attack, that is a modification of message. So that you will consider 1 and 2. Okay, 1 and 2. So instead of replay, you consider 1 and 2. So the actual message, the Darth will gain and he will modify that message and send that message to Alice. So in that case, the Alice will not receive the actual message. But in case of replay, Alice will also get the actual message. Okay, in the third case, that is modification of message, Alice will not get the actual message. Only she will get the altered message. Isn't it? Altered message. And the last type of attack, denial of service, that is, he will simply break that, what we call, the transmission. Whatever transmission, whatever transmission Bob is doing to Alice, he's simply... I mean, the Darth will simply deny the transmission. So such a thing, we call it as denial of service. No transmission has been occurred between Bob and Alice. So such a transmission is nothing but denial of service. Denial of service. These type of attacks, the active attacks, they are easy to detect. If you implement some kind of security measures, they are easy to detect. But they are very difficult to prevent. We cannot potentially prevent these type of active attacks because vulnerabilities, we have a lot of vulnerabilities. Vulnerabilities, they can be present in our system. They can be present through the transmission channel, or they can also be present at the receiver. So we have a lot of scope of presence of vulnerabilities. Because of that reason, the active attacks are very easy to detect, but very difficult to prevent. Very difficult to prevent. So, two types of attacks, passive attacks, active attacks, we discussed. Passive attacks, we said release of message content and traffic analysis. Active attacks, we said masquerade, replay, modification of message and denial of service. So these things you have to remember, and it is for your information, this security attacks or cryptographic attacks, it is an important question for your external exam. Definitely they will ask one question from this attacks concept. Okay, so the second type of attacks, that is security attacks, what type of attacks we can expect on our security mechanism. And these attacks, they are also classified or they are also categorized under four different types. The first one is interruption. The second, interception, modification and fabrication. So how these things in reality to understand will go one by one. The first one is interruption. Okay, interruption in the sense an asset of the system, whatever infrastructure, IT infrastructure we have. Okay, from that asset, from that infrastructure, some portion or either some portion or the complete system will be destroyed so that it will become unavailable or unusable. So simply what they will do, they will destroy either the complete transmission channel or any portion of your IT infrastructure. Because of that reason, the server or the transmission channel will become unavailable. Unavailable. So this type of attack, we are calling it as security attack, we are calling it as interruption. And this is an attack on availability, because after the attack, whatever service you have or whatever server you have, whatever transmission channel you have, that will become unavailable. Isn't it? That will become unavailable. So interruption is an attack on availability. Okay. So example you can see over here, destruction of any piece of hardware, cutting the communication channel or disabling the file management system. Definitely, whenever we are installing a file server, we are going to have some file management mechanisms. If a third party is coming and he is disabling that file management mechanisms, what will happen? The file system will become unavailable. The file system will become unavailable. And between the two systems, if you have a communication channel and a third party is coming and he is cutting the communication cable, communication line, so simply what will happen? Again, the communication or the transmission channel will become unavailable. If you have a hard drive or if you have a CD-ROM where you have some valuable information which is being shared over the internet and some third party is coming and he is destroying that hard drive or that CD-ROM, then also what will happen? Again, that part of hardware will become unavailable. So simply saying interruption is an attack on availability. So generally, how the transmission will be between source and destination. So if he is source and if he is destination. So if there are no attacks, the transmission will be one-to-one. The transmission will be one-to-one from source to destination like this. If this is your source and if this is your destination, the transmission will be from source to destination, one-to-one transmission without any alteration, without any modification, without any attack. The transmission will be one-to-one. That is, whatever message the source is sending, the same message the destination or the receiver has to receive without any alterations, without any modification. And it should not be disclosed. The message should not be disclosed to the third person or third party. The message should not be disclosed to the third party. So this type of transmission we are saying as the general transmission or a trusted transmission. So he is your intruder. So we are saying it as trusted transmission. So what happens in case of interruption that you can see over here? So see here, Alice is sending a message to Bob. Alice is trying to send a message to Bob. In case of interruption, what he is doing, the intruder, okay, an active intruder. So what he is doing, he is simply destroying that message. He is cutting that cable or he is deleting that message from the transmission channel or whatever he is doing. Simply, he is disabling the transmission between Alice and Bob. Okay. See over here, intruder intercepts the message in the middle and stops the communication these type of attack we are calling it as interruption. It is a kind of security attack and we are calling it as interruption. And this is an attack on availability. As you can see over here, this is an attack on availability. An active intruder will always be present. Whether there is an attack or not, an active intruder will always be present. So in case of interruption, he will simply disable that communication. So this is the first type of attack. The second security attack, that is interception. Okay. So here what will happen? An unauthorized or untrusted third party will gain the access to the assets. This is an attack on confidentiality. Authorized party could be a person or a program or a computer. Okay, so what he will do? He will act like a trusted party and he will get the complete information from the transmission. So this type of attack we said interception. Okay, wiretapping to capture the data in the network. Illicit copying of files. He's simply coming to your computer and he's connecting his pen drive and he's having your password. The unauthorized party gaining the access to your asset in the sense, if you have a locked computer, if you have some password on your computer, the unauthorized party is gaining the password. He's gaining the password by some means and he's coming to your computer and he's connecting his pen drive and opening that computer by typing the password and he's copying your valuable files into his pen drive. So this type of attack, we call it as interception. interception. If we show it graphically, so this one. So general transmission from Alice to Bob. General transmission from Alice to Bob. The intruder, he is gaining the information. He is gaining the information because he is also having the unauthorized access to your computer or to your transmission channel. Because of that reason only he is gaining the information from the network. Okay. So here as you can see, the intruder intercepts the message and views the message in the middle of the transmission. In the middle of the transmission. So this is an attack on confidentiality because you are sending some confidential information and the third person is gaining that information. Okay, the third person is gaining that information. That is the reason why we are calling this type of attack as an attack on confidentiality. Attack on confidentiality. So interception is an attack on confidentiality. So the third type of attack, that is modification. So here also the unauthorized intruder, unauthorized third party is not only gains the access but also tampers the assets, tampers the message. And this is an attack on integrity because whatever message you are sending, it is being changed. So there is no chance of integrity. Whenever the message got changed, there is no chance of integrity. So that is the reason why modification is an attack on integrity. So changing the values in the data file or altering the complete program or modifying the content of a message which is being transmitted in the network. So what the intruder will do, he will get the actual message and he will modify the content in that message and he will send some modified message to the third party. He will send the modified message to the third party. So that is the reason why we are saying the modification is an attack on integrity. It is a clear attack on integrity. So unauthorized person, what he will do over here, the intruder, what he will do over here, he will not only gains the access to the actual message, but also tampers the message, but also changes the message. Okay, so that the integrity will be lost. So that is the reason why we are saying modification is an attack on integrity of the message, integrity of the transmission channel. So if you see graphically that one, so over here you can see the actual message, it is not being transmitted to the Bob. As you can see, the actual message Alice is sending with right mark. The intruder is gaining that message and he is replacing that right mark with a cross mark, means an illicit message. Okay, an illicit message will be sent from intruder to Bob. And what Bob is thinking means that message is from Alice. So whatever content is there inside that message, which is coming from Alice. So intruder, he is gaining the message and he is changing the message. So this is an attack on integrity of the message. Integrity of the message. And the last type of attack, that is fabrication. Fabrication means instead of, okay, even if the third party is not receiving any message from the first party, what the third party or what the unauthorized party will do means he will simply inserts some counterfeit objects, means some illicit messages, some unwanted messages into the network, into the network or into the transmission channel, so that they will reach the second party, that is nothing but receiver. So what the third party will do, he will send some suspicious messages, okay, suspicious messages to the receiver by acting like a sender, by acting like a sender. So this is an attack on authenticity because those messages, whether they are coming from a trusted party or not, the second party is completely unaware. The second party is completely unaware that the messages which he is receiving, whether they are coming from the actual party or not, trusted party or not. That is the reason why this attack, the fabrication attack, is on authenticity of the message. Fabrication is the authenticity of the message. So as you can see over here, Alice is not sending any message. Simply the intruder, he is sending some unwanted messages to Bob. He is sending some unwanted messages to Bob. So here this attack is on authenticity of the network or authenticity of the message. Okay, intruder fabricating a message and sending and impersonating the sender. He is acting like the sender. He is acting like Alice and sending the unwanted messages to Bob. So impersonating means he is acting like Alice. Okay, so this is an attack on authenticity of the message. So these four types of attacks, we are considering them as a security attack. So we'll conclude our class over here with this concept. In our next class, we'll discuss the services of the security. Okay, what type of security services we have, and then we see mechanism, security mechanism, and we also see a network security model in our upcoming classes. Okay, thank you students, and hope you are doing well and staying safe at home. Thank you very much.